Hey everyone, today we're building the ultimate FPV drone, the AOS 3.5. I'll guide you through every step, from unboxing to assembly and highlight key upgrades. Plus, I'll let you know what I would do differently next time, so stay tuned. Let's take a closer look at the parts used in the final version. For the motors, I'm using the recommended SING with 3100kV from iFlight. For the flight stack, I'm using an AIO stack from Diatone. The Mamba F740 features a 40 amp ESC and built-in Wi-Fi. A printed version of the flight stack schematic is included in the package. The frame used here is the AOS 35 frame EVO, version 1.2. In this build, I will show two versions, a low-budget analog version and a digital version with a RunCam Wasp Nano, also known as the CADDIX Vista. For the analog version, we're using the SpeedyB TX800, which costs around $30. As mentioned, we're using a RunCam Wasp kit. I got it for a very good price, around $120. Here's a list of all the parts along with their prices. The digital version is not much more expensive. And now let's get started with the build. We begin with the lower part of the frame. Take the lower plates and connect them with the arms. The parts are stacked like a sandwich and secured with a screw and an aluminum standoff. Don't make the same mistake I did. I forgot to screw in the bolts for the flight stack. These must be inserted beforehand. I have to say, this part kind of looks like a frog. The assembly is quite simple since the same screws are always used from the bottom. Don't forget to tighten all the screws properly, otherwise they may come loose during flight due to vibrations. Good, now let's mount the motors. First, attach the TPU dampeners to the frame from below. Place the motors on top and screw them in from underneath. What do you think about the TPU dampers? Should we skip them to save weight? Let me know in the comments. In this frame, the motors are held in place with just three screws each. Finally, secure the cable channels with double-sided tape. Do you prefer cable channels or black electrical tape? Now, let's connect the all-in-one flight stack with the silicone dampeners. These dampeners are crucial for reducing vibrations, so they aren't detected by the gyro. Any vibration that isn't properly filtered out will be greatly amplified in the D-term. Now, let's mount the flight stack on the frame and secure it with self-locking nuts. Tighten the nuts so the flight stack isn't loose, but the dampeners still have space to absorb vibrations. Let's start with the soldering. But wait, stop. These solder joints look like trash. And here's the first update to my AOS 35. After many flights, I wanted to redo the solder joints. And this time, use your advice to apply more flux. Thanks again for your support in the comments. The solder joints have improved significantly, but they're still not perfect. However, they are sufficient for now. I'm grateful for any tips you leave in the comments. Let's go ahead and try the smoke test. That sounds good. In the meantime, I treated myself to this electric screwdriver. Makes FPV life much easier. I route the ELR's antenna underneath the air unit. Now, let's mount the analog VTX at the rear of our quadcopter. Take four long screws and secure them with nylon nuts to the frame. The order doesn't matter. You can solder the motors first and then mount the VTX, or do it the other way around. Next, screw in the VTX. I used four O-rings as dampeners, although it might not be necessary. It didn't hurt to protect the electronics from strong vibrations. If you're enjoying this video, please like and subscribe. It helps with the algorithm and your support means a lot to me. Now, solder the VTX to the flight controller. Let's take another look at the flight controller's pin layout. Lastly, we'll solder the analog camera to the flight controller. Now let's solder the ELR's receiver to the flight controller. Remember to swap RX and TX. RX from the receiver goes to TX on the flight controller. I'm using 2.4 GHz Express LRS, but I'm curious about your experiences with the system. Let me know in the comments. As promised, here's another update on my AOS 35. After flying with the analog version for a few weeks, I switched to digital. Installing the Vista is super easy since you only need to solder on the Vista itself. The Mamba flight controller connects with a plug. Now, let's install the camera cage. Secure it with four screws and two aluminum standoffs, then simply insert it into the frame. The top plate screws will fix it in position. I secured the ELR's receiver to the Vista with double-sided tape. I couldn't think of a better way. If you have any tips, please leave them in the comments. I also secured the Vista's cables to the frame with a zip tie to prevent them from hitting the flight controller. Now let's screw the top plate to the frame. Next, we'll screw on the TPU action camera mount. I'm using it for an Insta360 Go 2. I secured the ELR's receiver antenna with a 3D printed TPU holder attached to the bottom plate. I will link all the STL files in the video description. Lastly, the props. The recommended props are from HQ with a 2.5 pitch, but I switched to the Avan props with a 2.8 pitch. I must say, the difference is significant. I highly recommend using the Avan props for this setup. And here is the final result, along with the Insta360 Go 2. Now, I'd like to share some things I would do again, and some I wouldn't. First, I would directly install a CADX Vista or a DJI O3, depending on the budget. Second, I wouldn't mount an Insta360 anymore. Instead, I'd go for a DJI Action 2, or a GoPro session. If sound isn't important, you can rely on the O3. Third, I wouldn't use an AIO stack again because it's expensive and needs to be replaced entirely. A stack allows you to replace the flight controller or ESC separately. If you enjoyed this video, I've linked another one here, where I build a 5-inch copter. Check it out. Since you watched to the end, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Share it and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Feel free to leave any questions or feedback in the comments below. I look forward to hearing from you. See you in the next video.
fade to gray.